effectively. We haven't been able to throw it effectively at all. So, and I don't think it's just all the quarterback. I think it's the whole group. We got to get open. We got to protect better. And, you know, defensively, we're making too many mistakes, especially on third down when we got a chance to get off the field. So, had plenty of chances to stay in the ball game and get things fixed at halftime.
Appreciate it. Thank you, Nick.
All right, thanks.
The running backs, if you take Hurts' running away, and we mentioned the possibility. There's Jalen Hurts, of course, who's 25-2 as a starter. Tagovailoa, who's the true freshman, who can throw the football well. And this game gets to a point where they're not executing at the line of scrimmage, and they need to throw. Wouldn't be surprised if he gets a shot.
Now, you're right, Nick Saban. It would take a lot to pull a guy who's been clutch in his career and has won 25 out of 27 starts, but that's how much they think of the passing skills of Tagovailoa. It is a pretty thing to watch that lefty spin it. So we'll see. Tide get the football first. And here it is. Tua Tagovailoa, a true freshman from Hawaii, gets the second half start. He keeps it. He's a nifty runner, not quite as powerful as Hurts, but he's in there because he's throwing it.
He is known as a distributor, a great passer, a guy who has come in, and even though he hasn't played a lot of meaningful snaps, the players believe in him. The players, the receivers especially, really believe that he can make the throws to give them a chance to be more balanced than with Jalen Hurts in there.
It's still a remarkable move by head coach, and Tagovailoa from the pocket spins it. It's an accurate throw, short, complete to Hale Henches.
With him in there, quarterback.
Tagovailoa steps up, now looks to escape, cuts it back. Flag is down very late in the play, about a 4-yard gain. Dogs don't pressure. Tagovailoa has all night, hit hard, spinning around, trying to escape and create, and now he's in the clear. The freshman shows some toughness, creating a desperately needed third down conversion.
Georgia plays man under with two deep. He has all day. Quarterback's actually much more mobile. Tagovailoa much more mobile, but also strong. Low center of gravity, gets out of there and picks up the first down.
Anna in Georgia territory at the 44. First down throw, a slant high, caught. Robert Foster, the senior, just his 12th of the season.
To get the ball out quickly.
Second and one, throwing again, slant low, and it's Ruggs, the freshman, going down again. First and goal, Alabama.
This is what a lot of Alabama fans have talked about, the possibility of Tagovailoa someday maybe getting an opportunity. What it's done, Chris, because of the play calling, boy, it's changed the energy and the attitude from that Georgia defense. Got to execute down here. They need six.
Throwing again. End zone. Touchdown! Henry Ruggs. We got a freshman quarterback duel in Atlanta, and the Tide are back in it. That's good advice. He hasn't been under fire much in meaningful games, as we said. Rolls, flips it high, into traffic, intercepted. DeAndre Baker made the young fellow pay for a mistake.
Set, quick, ball's coming out quick.
Dogs rush five, does come out. Ridley, Calvin finally makes a play. He is slung down by J.R. Reed. And Najee getting the turn. That time they fake it to him. Tagovailoa has lots of time and a big cushion for Cam Sims, who makes the catch. Still fighting, spinning, takes a big shot. Get it at quick. Foster, two blocks on the edge, and they move the ball into the Dogs' territory. Damian Harris comes in motion. Tagovailoa fakes the run, and now is going to flip it to Harris in the flat. Makes a man miss, and Damian Harris, after a frustrating night, spins across the 50 into Georgia territory.
Productive with Tagovailoa in there.
The lefty fires downfield. Judy goes up. Freshman to freshman again, and the Tide set up inside the 15. He's following his height there.
Chris, look at the background right here. Watch how he's man-to-man, and then the guy just lets go of him. It looked like it was Tyreek McGee. He was running with him, and then midway through the route, he aborted, relied on somebody else. There was no one else there, and Tagovailoa does a good job of recognizing it, putting the ball there where Judy can go up and make a great play.
Keeper. Tagovailoa cuts it back. He's shifty. Down to the six.
They got a nice push. Short. Got a nice push there from Pierce Baker.
Tagovailoa, plenty of time. Surveying the field. Fires end zone. Touchdown! Calvin Ridley finally makes an impact. The superstar receiver waited all night for that moment. He'd been targeted. He'd been missed. That time, Tagovailoa coolly spins it to him. And now Papanastos to tie the game at 20. 3:49 to play. Alabama. 20 points after halftime, all with Tagovailoa at quarterback.
So he's going to look to his right to hit Ridley right away, but you're going to see Dominic Sanders get in the way of the route. Right here, look at his eyes. He's trying to go right here, but you have Sanders who takes that away. What's great is Ridley doesn't give up on the play. Keeps working against man-to-man, pulls away from Aaron Davis. A great effort, and how about the moxie and the poise by the young freshman quarterback sitting in that pocket, fourth down, game on the line potentially, and he throws an absolute rope on the run, defense closing in on him, throws it away from the defense, and Ridley makes the play.
There's no structure to that play. That's just street ball in downtown Atlanta. Nick Saban says, finally, we're back even. And that decision to pull number two there, Jalen Hurts, 25-2 as a starter. Right now looking like a genius move.
No doubt about it. Took guts to make the move. Definitely has created a spark.
A chance to win Nick Saban's sixth national championship.
A year ago, he's leaving Hawaii and enrolling in college in Alabama, trying to figure out where the dorms are and where's he walking around to go to class. And Jalen Hurts continues to support him, which is one of the coolest things I've seen tonight, being a great teammate.
Tagovailoa's family moving from Hawaii here to Alabama. His younger brother's a talented prospect in high school, too. Bo testing the mettle of this Dawgs defense. Tagovailoa sideline round. It's easy pitch and catch to Ridley. Be careful. Calvin Ridley starting to get involved now. Run all the way. Chase down at the 25. Keeper. Tagovailoa lowers the head, shows the power, and gets a first down. He just ran over the senior Sanders.
Yeah, he went right over top of him. Mentioned how strong he is, his lower body, for being a young player. People forget that he can run the ball, and he's not only slippery and quick, but he can be powerful. This is a big third down and short. Dominic Sanders comes up. Safety up at the top, comes down quickly along with Carter. He's right there to make the play.
Talking about a guy.
Tagovailoa lowers that shoulder and gets more yards.
Yeah, he's never started a game. Tagovailoa barely played, running over a dude who's making his 53rd start in college football. Great keeper, and Tagovailoa moves it to the right hash. Run to the right. Tagovailoa knocked down at the 15. They'll keep
out there.
Papanastos for the national championship from 36 yards. Headed for overtime. You feel for any kicker comes up short in that situation.
Yeah.
Chubb met. Battles for just a few yards. You got to believe in your offensive line. Chubb behind the fullback Payne. He's got it. Cannot get the corner. Levi Wallace stopped him. It's going to be third down. Brusher flush, sacked way back at the 35-yard line. It will be a very long field goal attempt coming up. And there's Blankenship trying to give Georgia the lead. Hot Rod just slides it through.
At the end of regulation.
Saban jumping around way out on the field. Gesturing to his offense. Tagovailoa. Dancing around. Circling back. Dropped! A disastrous first down play. Devin Bellamy got it back at the 42.
Chris, that's a combination of great coverage downfield by Georgia and just being a young quarterback not put in this situation. Bellamy almost gets him there. See, that's where you'd like to see him throw it away. Nobody's open. You got to give up on the play, throw it away, get outside of the pocket and play on second and 10. That's his youth right there.
Think about Loa trying to make up for it. Fires to the end zone. Touchdown! Alabama wins! The Crimson Tide will not be denied. True freshman to true freshman. Tagovailoa to Devontae Smith. Alabama breaks Georgia hearts.
And a night when we've talked so much about freshmen, it's true freshman to true freshman to win the game for Alabama.
A 41-yarder after the sack, delivering the victory in overtime to Alabama.
Of your life. When did you find out that you were going in?
I mean, I found out when we were in the locker room. You know, coach brought the quarterbacks together and he made the statement that, you know, Tua, you're going to start out the second half and, you know, we're going to rotate the quarterbacks, you know, see how things go. So we went from there.
What went through your mind when coach let you know you were about to play in a national championship game?
You know, my parents would be mad, but, you know, excuse me. You know, first and foremost, I'd just like to thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. You know, with him, all things are possible, and that's what happened tonight, you know. But, I mean, it was a team effort tonight, you know. Couldn't have been done without the defense getting us the ball back. You know, our O-line blocking, working their butts off, as well as our receivers. You know, it was just a great team effort. You know, and they were the guys that made me look good tonight, so.
When you saw that field goal was hooked left, you knew you would have to take the field one more time and try to win this game. I mean, what were you saying before you took the field again?
I mean, I didn't say anything, you know, just going back in, just take it a play at a time, and that's what happened.
Now that you're a national champion, as a true freshman, I mean, describe what it means for you in this moment.
You know, in this moment, I mean, it means the world. But at the same time, I mean, all glory goes to God. You know, I can't describe what he's done for me and my family, you know. Who would have ever thought I would have been here, you know, right now. In this moment. So, you know, I thank God for that. And, you know, I just like to thank my teammates and Coach Saban for giving me the opportunity.
And describe what you saw on that final game-winning play.
They had split safety. You know, the safety on Devontae's side, on the single receiver side, he tried to disguise his coverage. I tried to look him off. He stayed in the middle, and then I went back outside. It was a cover two on their side, you know, but he stayed inside. So, I mean, I took a shot downfield, and he caught it.
Congratulations, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
We'll be right back.